Yeah.
Chairing time with Deputy Coffinger.
15 minutes seven, between you, yep.
7.5 each, is it?
It's fine.
Minister, there's nothing I would like more than to believe that this plan was going to deliver. I do think everybody in this House wants to solve the problem. How could they not, given the scale of hardship and suffering that people who are homeless in emergency accommodation or who are waiting on housing lists for 15 to 18 years with really little or no hope of ever being housed, how could you not want to solve this problem? And I do believe, setting aside everything else I'm going to say in a minute, that everybody wants to solve the problem. But I don't think, when you look at the detail of this plan, as I haven't read every word, but I've read it pretty closely, that this is going to deliver. And I think it won't deliver, really, because it doesn't take on board not just what people like ourselves have been saying since 2011, but what was confirmed by the chairperson of the Housing Finance Agency this morning, when she summed up, really, and summarised what we've been saying for 5 years, and I think it stands as the most accurate critique of what isn't in this, the failure of this plan to actually get to the kernel of the problem. She said, we have become too dependent on the private sector to house low-income households. If we are going to deliver houses, we need, in the short term, in my view, local authorities to be reintroduced to building at a large scale that will involve them having permission to borrow money. So the local authorities must directly deliver council housing, and be allowed to borrow, given the money to do it directly themselves. She recognises the problem, and she's right. Now, the question is this plan proposing to do that? And it's not. It is littered with references to incentives, to private developers, to vulture funds, to competitiveness. It doesn't mention the vulture funds specifically, but it talks about big land, those who will build in large-scale rental property. That's the vulture funds. That is the vulture funds. The people who own the land, who bought up the land, who bought up the property. And the most telling confirmation that my assessment of this is right was when I asked the Taoiseach today, could he tell me how many council houses, local authority houses, would be built under the plan? And he admitted, frankly, he couldn't give me an answer to that question. And it's not in the plan, Minister. I've heard since, I presume coming from you, from journalists, who I suspect, like everybody else, want to believe this plan is a new departure, because everybody really does want to believe it is a new departure. Like we all wanted to believe that Anne Kelly's plan was going to change things, but didn't. But he couldn't answer the question, and this report doesn't answer the question, how many council houses? And the nearest it gets to answering it is on page 45, where it says, with cooperation and mobilisation by local authorities and AHBs, the action plan envisages a significant progressive increase in social housing build activity to over 5,000 homes a year by 2021. Now, let's read that carefully. So it's not 5,000 a year to 2021, which would still only amount to 25,000, and it wouldn't all be council, because some of it would be approved housing bodies, but you hope to get up to 5,000 in 2021. Right? So of the headline figure of 47,000, which sounds good, social housing units, less than 25,000, in fact, I suspect it's very considerably less than 25,000, will be actual council houses, local authority houses. Now, when you consider that in the time of the last government, the housing list has gone from 96,000 to, we don't quite know what it is now, I think 140,000 families and households,
up by over 45,000. If the rate of increase in the housing list continues, we will have a longer council housing list at the end of this plan than we now have. Because this plan does not envisage, at the centre of its strategy, the local authorities taking the advice of the Housing Finance Agency and getting back to the direct provision of local authority housing in large scale, as she says. And it doesn't. Well, why are the figures not in it? And even now, can you tell me how many council houses? How many council houses, Minister? The Taoiseach couldn't answer, and I bet you can't. Yeah.
Not questions. Continue.
Yeah. And no. Gino Kenny showed up, and it isn't in the report, Minister. Right? It is not in the report. And the bulk of it is HAPS and RAS. Now, Minister, again, for the desperate people coming into my office on a daily basis, I really want. I mean, I disagree fundamentally with the principle of HAPS, but I'd like to think for the desperate people coming in, at least I could say, well, there you go. It's not a council house, but it's something. But I can tell you it's not going to happen. It just, the numbers, you might get some of it, but you won't get anything like the targets that you're talking about, Minister. Why would they sign up? There's no evidence that they're signing up in significant numbers. Why would they? They're not. Maria, I know from my own locality. They are not. I mean, I read these figures out the other day, Minister, and I'll just let me do it again. Even with your increased rent caps or your HAP limits, rent levels in Dunleary Rathdown for a single one bedroom are 1,800. Double your limits. Why would a private landlord enter into an arrangement with you for a cap of 1,300 when average rents are 1,800? Why would, for a three-bedroom, would they enter into an arrangement with you when the average is 2,200 and all they can get off you is 1,300? Why would they do it? They will not do it, Minister. And that is the problem. I haven't got time, sadly, to go into the detail, so it is often the case. The reliance on the private sector, the ideological blindness, the kowtowing to the developers and them telling you we can't make enough profits, that's why we won't build and deliver the social housing or the affordable housing, and we keep kowtowing to them and they still don't deliver and we don't get the social housing, the council housing that we actually need solve the problem.
Thank you. Deputy Coppinger.
I just gave them to you.
Just
build council
seven
houses.
7 minutes, Deputy. Without interruption, okay. Please. Deputy Coppinger.